Use procedure 1001, preformed band clamp selection if needed. Prepare the hose using procedure 1100, general preparation instructions. Insert the stem. For hoses 3-inch ID, as shown here, and larger, a 5/8 inch wide band clamp must be installed prior to installing the strap grip clamps. For hoses 3-inch ID, as shown here, and larger, a 5/8 inch wide band clamp must be installed prior to installing the strap grip clamps. For this, position one strap grip clamp so that the gripping finger properly engages the stem collar. Place marks on the hose that correspond with the inside edges of both saddles. Remove the clamp and set it aside. Position a preformed band clamp between the marks on the hose. Install and properly tension the clamp per one of the following instructions. Procedure 2100, installation of preformed band clamps using pneumatic rollover tool. Procedure 2103, installation of preformed band clamps using screw action tool with rollover tool attachment. Or, as shown here, procedure 2101, installation of preformed band clamps using punch style tool. An oversized clamp is being used here for illustration purposes. After the clamp has been properly tensioned, set the lock and remove the clamp tail. Once the sealing band has been installed, place one of the strap grip clamps back on the hose with the gripping finger engaging the stem collar. With the buckle of the sealing band 90 degrees to the strap grip clamp, secure the clamp in place with tape. Place the second strap grip clamp opposite the first clamp with the gripping finger engaging the stem collar. Secure it in place with tape. Following procedure 1102, clamp at band and buckle preparation, place the two clamps over the saddles of the strap grip clamps. For assemblies below 3-inch, place the clamp buckles on opposite sides of each other. For our 3-inch assembly here and larger, place the clampet buckles on the same side, but opposite the sealing clamp buckle. The clampet buckles must be between the strap grip saddles. With the screw action tool, snug the clampet band furthest away from the hose end. Do not tighten excessively, as this may prevent the gripping finger of the strap grip clamp from engaging the stem collar properly. Bend the clamp tail back over the buckle, release the pulling dog lever, and remove the tool. Install the screw action tool on the clampet band closest to the hose end. Snug the clamp. Bend the clamp tail back over the buckle, release the pulling dog lever, and remove the tool. Returning to the clampet band furthest away from the hose end, install the tool on the clamp tail and properly tension the clamp as per procedure 2104, installation of clampet band and buckle using screw action tool. When proper tension has been achieved, follow the steps in procedure 2104 to cut and secure the clamp tail stub. Moving back to the clampet band closest to the hose end, properly tension the clamp, then cut the clamp tail and secure the tail stub as per the instructions of procedure 2104. As you can see, both clampet buckles are on the same side, placed midway between the strap grip clamp saddles. The sealing clamp buckle is on the opposite side, placed midway between the strap grip clamp saddles. Both strap grip clamp gripping fingers must engage the stem collar sufficiently. For assemblies below 3-inch, a minimum of 1/32nd of an inch engagement is required. For assemblies 3-inch and above, the minimum engagement is 1/16th of an inch. Also, inspect the assembly using procedure 3002, band clamp inspection. Test the assembly using procedure 4000, general hydrostatic testing information, and procedure 4001, hydrostatic testing.
Dixon, the right connection.